Welcome to this week's River Valley Leader Top 5. This week's show is full of breaking news, so let's get started. Coming in at number 5 is a man pleads guilty to negligent homicide in Russellville. Jonathan Williams pled guilty to a negligent homicide charge at the Pope County Courthouse on Friday, April 20th. Williams took the plea deal and will spend the next 12 months in the Pope County Detention Center. According to the police report, Williams contacted 911 around 2:48 a.m. on July 25, 2010, to report that his four-month-old son was not breathing. He told dispatch the baby was not breathing and he had been performing CPR on the child. The baby was transported to St. Mary's Emergency Room by Pope County EMS and then airlifted to Arkansas Children's Hospital. Days later, the baby died on August 4, 2010. According to the autopsy report performed by the state medical examiner's office, the cause of death was head injuries and the manner of death was homicide. St. Mary's personnel told officers that the baby displayed signs of shaken baby syndrome. Williams was home alone with the child at the time of the incident. After being awakened by a phone call, he said that he walked by the playpen the baby was sleeping in and heard the baby was having trouble breathing. He picked the baby up and told officers that he seemed limp. According to officers, he then shook the baby pretty violently and next administered CPR and called the baby's mother along with 911. When asked how hard he shook the baby on a scale from 1 to 10, Williams told officers that it was a 6. When Williams appeared in front of Judge Pearson on Friday, April 20th, Pearson found factual basis for his charges. Williams received 12 months in jail, over $1,000 in fines, and currently has 2 days credit for already time served. Now moving on to a breaking news story from last week. At 4:32 a.m., Wednesday, April 25th, Pope County 911 received a call of a structure fire at 6344 Market Street and Highway 7 North. Dover Fire and Rescue and Dover Marshals Office responded to the call. When they arrived, authorities discovered Hampton Gun and Pond fully engulfed in flames. The building contained many firearms and ammunition, as well as other merchandise. The cause of the fire is unknown at this time, and property is a total loss. As of 9 a.m. Wednesday, authorities were still on the scene. Moving on to the number 3 most read story of the week. Fatality accident on Highway 7 North. Arkansas State Police responded to a motor vehicle accident on State Highway 7 involving a 2002 Chevrolet truck and a 2006 Toyota Camry. The accident occurred on Thursday, April 19th at 6:15 a.m. Carnetta Williams, age 73, of Dover, was traveling northbound on Highway 7 when her vehicle was struck head-on by a 2002 Chevrolet truck traveling southbound. The Chevrolet truck, driven by Michael Brown, 34, of Dover, proceeded into the northbound lane and struck the Toyota Camry. Brown was transported by Pope County EMS to St. Mary's Regional Medical Center to be treated for his injuries. Mrs. Williams succumbed to her injuries upon impact, and the next of kin was notified. Preliminary summary indicates both drivers were wearing seat belts at the time of the accident. The weather conditions were clear and the roadway was dry. Another breaking news story comes in at number 2, ATV fatality in Pope County. At approximately 6:40 p.m. Saturday, April 21st, local county authorities responded to the community of Treat in northern Pope County on a fatal four-wheeler accident involving a 46-year-old man. Pope County coroner has confirmed the fatality accident. Pope County Sheriff's Office and deputies of the Pope County Coroner's Office are currently working on this incident, stated Pope County Coroner Leonard Kraut. We will release more information once the investigation becomes complete. And that was all at the time of the incident. Now moving on to the number 1 story of the week. Arkansas State Police responded to a 2-vehicle accident that occurred on Highway 7 North near Round Rock at approximately 7:15 a.m. on Thursday, April 19th. Traffic was delayed as authorities cleared the roadway. The injured parties were transported by Pope County EMS to St. Mary's Regional Medical Center, and the extent of their injuries were unknown at the time of the article. All these stories and many more can be found on rivervalleyleader.com. Don't forget to head out to all of the events going on in the River Valley this weekend. The RHS Theater Department is presenting Andy Get Your Gun at the Center for the Arts on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and Russellville City Park will come alive with Party in the Park on Saturday. Be sure to venture out this weekend. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.